This is Roosevelt Gist with AutoNetwork, and we're here in Virginia with Dodge for the launch of the new Dodge Ram MegaCab. Extraordinary, supersized, as you can see. And my guest on the show is Erik Ridenour, the Executive Vice President of Product Development until January 1st, and we'll talk about that later. Erik, thanks for taking the time.
Hey, my pleasure. Thanks for inviting me.
Now, in the truck business, is it true that bigger is better?
I think it definitely is. I think as we go into this segment, we look at the Mega Cab. This is the biggest truck and the biggest cab in the world. And for that customer that's looking for that extra room and the ability, family, gear behind the seat, lots of leg room, this is a perfect vehicle.
Now, during the presentation, you had a lot of the best, the biggest in this particular segment. Mm-hmm. Will all of that best and biggest kind of bump you up in the numbers in terms of meeting your sales goals?
Definitely it helps us a lot. I mean, I think you have different image vehicles, you have your volume vehicles. I think a customer's looking for the little bit of advantage that you get when you decide to buy a Dodge versus one of the competition, and we intend to give them those advantages and hopefully bring them into the showroom, and then once they get a chance to see and drive it, we're convinced they'll want to buy.
Now, I noticed when you first came out with this design of the Dodge, which had that menacing grille, if you look through the rearview mirror, it looked like a semi was coming behind you. Now you're adding a supersized cab. What's the target audience for that type of product?
It really is a very traditional pickup truck customer. I mean, they're a type of customer who really wants to be known and be proud of the vehicle that they're in. Have it not just blend in with the crowd, but in fact make a statement. And we think this the aggressive look of the front end carried through into the vehicle is exactly what they're looking for.
Do you think it's more difficult to design for truck customers than it is versus car customers, or there's no difference in your mind?
I think each customer group has their own challenges from the standpoint of really making sure that we understand what they really want and not try and put our own opinions, but in fact really listen to the customers. So we spend a lot of time in different research groups, talking to people one-on-one, being at focus groups, watching them use their vehicles and those kinds of things to make sure that we really understand why. And the questions we're always trying to figure out is, you know, what is it that you don't get out of today's vehicles? What is the unmet needs? What is the thing that if you had it, you'd be great, but we may not even be able to verbalize? So we find different ways to try and get those kinds of feelings, and that's what allows something like a Mega Cab to come into being. For a minivan, it was stow-and-go seats, a very obvious thing now that we've done it, but before we did it, obviously went a long time without those features. And I think we keep trying to find those kinds of different features that really help set us apart and give our customers what they're really looking for.
Now, what's going to determine the success of a Mega Cab?
Well, I think clearly it'll be both what's the sales success, so volume will be very, very important, but we also very much look at how the customer talks about it as we get different third-party studies. We get media comments from yourself and others, and we look at the buff books, and we try and get a gauge. So, you know, success isn't just numbers, but it's numbers plus image. Is it consistent with the brand? Is it customers really happy that they made the choices they made? Are they being satisfied? Do they want to buy another? I mean, obviously, this is all about making sure customers are really satisfied.
Now, as you know, Toyota is putting a nice-sized truck factory in San Antonio. Texas happens to be probably the largest truck market. How does that change your strategy, or does that make you a little hesitant?
Well, definitely not hesitant. I think we welcome all competition. I don't walk away from competition. Clearly, that's done very much on purpose. Clearly, you know, Texas is the heart of the truck market, and you know, we intend to compete there and everywhere else. And you know, we compete on product and we compete on features, and that's the things we work first and foremost on. And I think as long as we keep bringing out great products, you know, we'll let the competition come, and hopefully they'll dine on others.
What's been the response of the dealer body for this particular truck?
It's been really good, and I think it allows them to really set it apart. And again, you know, for those that are looking for the size, then clearly this is the biggest. We have a lot of other variants because not every customer is looking for this. So we have through the whole range of trucks, both in payload and trailer tone characteristics. We have a range of powertrain options. We have a range of size options and bed options and all those things. And this is just one more flavor we think will be very popular, both from the commercial side for true crew cab kind of customers, but also from a family side, allow that, you know, you can really go on vacation, carry a lot of your gear and have the people and have the DVD system and the video system and all those things and really make it a good family vehicle. So we think it has a really good blend of those characteristics, and we think that'll be really popular.
Now, do you think geographically you'll pick up any market share with a product like this?
We absolutely have to, and that's the whole reason for doing it. Obviously, it's to not just have people substitute from what they would have bought from us and instead decide to buy this one, but in fact also bring some conquest people in, people who otherwise would have loved to have a Dodge, but we didn't quite have what they wanted. Now with this, we're able to expand that and give the additional 20 inches of room that's back here versus our current quad cab offering, and really give the customer something different.
Now, as of January 1, you're going to be moving on, as they say, up the ladder to Chief Operating Officer of the Chrysler Group. How do you feel about taking that move where you've been pretty much, I guess, hands-on when you talk about product development?
I think I'll still be pretty hands-on from the standpoint of the product. Obviously, I pick up some additional responsibilities with manufacturing and some of the other areas of the company, and the responsibility for the overall day-to-day implementation side of the business, but I'll still very much be involved in product and continue that. So with all jobs always, there's pluses and minuses to everything. I'm looking forward. I'm very excited about it. I'm very honored to have been picked and look forward to the challenges.
Now, there's a lot of movement in Daimler Chrysler from the top, I guess, all of, and obviously when it moves at the top, there's movement below that. And I'm sure you already have your strategies in place for different products, especially this particular truck. Will those change with new people coming in?
Really, for us, I think not. I think the good part about Chrysler is we've always been sort of a choir, which is a lot of people involved in the decision-making around product. We have experts from a lot of different areas that we weigh in as a team and talk about whether we want to do the MegaCab or whatever the next product might be, and we talk the pros and cons and really get it down and have good discussions. So the strategy was set by that whole team. The majority of that team is still in place. Clearly, at least one of our members moved up to another bigger role with Dieter Zetsche moving up, but I still expect him to still stay somewhat involved as much as his schedule permits. Tom Lasorda moving up to CEO will still stay very much involved. I move from one position to another, but still sitting there. The person who's following me has also been involved and certainly been very involved in product. So I think we'll very much stay along the same course. I think we'll keep watching the competition and watching that, and we'll keep tweaking our strategy and our product lineup as we see where the customers want to go, and we look at the competitive environment and the external factors that are going on, and we'll just keep on finding good hits.
Other than the living room size of this this mega cab, what excites Eric about the product?
Well, I think it really sets itself apart, both in, like I said, the you can see it, clearly see it. In most cases for pickups, there's always been a little bit of room issues, and always as the market went from standard pickups first to extended cabs, and then we grew on that a little bit with the quad cab, and now crew cab has been very strong, and you can keep seeing this need, and this just takes it yet to the next dimension and really gives you the ability. You know, we have the reclining seats in the back, we have plenty of leg room and storage room, but even more versatile is the way it can flip and give you flat storage and be able to load with that doors that almost open 90 degrees, allow you to load a lot of cargo in here if that's what you need to carry, and then still have a very good bed in the back for carrying things that way. So again, I think it's a lot of versatility, and it's all wrapped up, and it's always nice to be, you know, bragging rights is always kind of fun too.
Well, great, Eric. Thanks for taking the time.
All right, well, thank you.
And good luck in the new position come January 1.
Thank you very much. I appreciate that.
This is Roosevelt Gist with Auto Network, and I'm dining, well, I'm not dining, but I'm quite relaxed in the back of this new Ram MegaCab. As always, please buckle up, don't drink and drive. See you next time.